Yeah, it's been a very active pattern, of course, that has brought all of this rainfall. Really, since the beginning of June, we saw this switch in the pattern, and that has meant a lot of heavy rainfall, particularly in these areas of yellow and, of course, the orange, too. So these numbers here, this is how much rain has fallen since June 1st. Now, keep in mind, usually over that time frame, we'd be talking maybe 3, 4, or 5 inches of rain. Many places easily pushing 10 plus. Berlin now reporting 11.77 inches. Look at Waterville Valley, over a foot of rainfall in that time. Newport in the orange there, over 17 inches of rain. So these areas in particular are very vulnerable to additional flash flooding. And the problem is we still have this active weather pattern basically right on top of us. The jet stream, which is a fast moving river of air about 40,000 feet up above our heads. It's the dividing line between cooler air to the north, warmer air to the south, and essentially it is blocked right over top of us. So that allows storm system after storm system to ride right along it and bring us this unsettled weather. So that's why really we haven't been able to have a stretch of days where we get just full sunshine. Instead, you get maybe a quick break, then the next storm system rolls on through, all because of the positioning of the jet stream. Now, yesterday, of course, many of you might have experienced this. We had tornado warnings. Thankfully, no tornado damage reported or one touching down. The most recent tornado touching down was in 2022 when we had one in Chesterfield and then one in North Charlestown. Now we're coming up on the anniversary of the July 24th, 2008 tornado, which was the longest track tornado in New England history, over 50 miles. Each year, we typically have 1 to 2 tornadoes that touched down in any given year in New Hampshire. Yesterday we had a watch, as many of you know. It had been a while, almost 3 years since we've had that.